नमस्ते, फ्रॉम नेपाल इट्स मी डॉक्टर हरि प्रसाद कणेल एज अ प्रेजेंटर फॉर टुडेज सेशन. आई एम अ हेड टीचर एज वेल एज अ टीचर यूनियन लीडर हियर. आई हैव बीन ज्वाइनिंग दिस प्रोग्राम सिंस अर्ली फेजेस. इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ग्लोबल प्रोफेशनल हैज अ मिशन ऑफ एम्पावरिंग पीपल थ्रू अवेकिंग द सेंस ऑफ कल्चरल preservation and transmission to a new generation around the world. I like this mission myself and decided to support it. Let's move together to make a strong solidarity for this campaign. I would like to welcome you all in today's session. I request you all to abide the rules of decentness while we are in program. We believe our learning passion always leads us. Friends, I would like to introduce today's guest speaker. It's our glorious moment that we have got the renowned human resource development catalyst, lawmaker, practitioner. She is Poulomi Ghosh Naim from Hyderabad, India. She is an international licensed master trainer, a certified human resource consultant, and learning development professional with a flair of creativity, excellence, and perfectionism. She has over 22 and a half years of experience in leading global training design and delivery teams, spawning American Pakistan Public Affairs Committee, North America and Latin America countries. She has earned many university degrees in different disciplines. She is skilled in building global operational excellence and across the learning function and has led numerous global projects and deployment of learning sites. She is a life and business coach, a change catalyst, and a board member of National Human Resource Development of Hyderabad. She has gained a lot of presentation experience on leadership development, organizational development, motivational coaching, emotional intelligence, and preservation of sexual harassment. Shortly, we pronounce post training. She is a strong believer of 6 P's. We know that under 6 P's, passion, preservation, perfection, planning, performance, and passion in life is essential. We are very lucky to have her in today's session. Let's listen and watch her. Enjoy the session with your full passion. Without being more delay, I would like to request to Honorable Mrs. Poulomi to start the session. Are you ready, ma'am?
Yes, yes, I'm ready. Thank you.
Okay. You can start your session. All the best.
All right. How are you? Thank you. Thank you so much. That was a, you know, that was a wonderful introduction. I'm very happy that, you know, today I am able to go live, especially for the Institute of Global Professionals. And this is a very, very, it's a wonderful opportunity and it's a great program because we always talk about performance management. And since I belong to the human resource department and it's been like more than 2 decades, it's a wonderful journey so far. And this is one of the subjects, performance management, which is very, very close to my profession, which is very close to my heart. So we will have a wonderful interactive discussion because I would like to know from everyone what it means to all of you when we talk about performance management, because anyway, I know about it, but I want to hear from you. If you can please type it on the, you know, on the comment box and let me know. So my first question before we even begin is, can anybody please define what is performance management? What does performance management mean to you? If you can just type it in the comment box, then I will be able to check on that. Thank you. There are so many people who are still joining. Thank you for that. So I'm just looking forward to a good definition of performance management. Good evening to everyone. I'm not able to type because I am on live. Okay, somebody said it's rating our employees' performance. Okay, all right. Looking for other definitions. Okay. I can get some definitions here, but I think this is a Google language. Can I have it in your own language, please? Okay. I get process of evaluation. Okay. All right. Okay. I think that the very, very interesting. Okay. I got some, interesting comments on the definition part of it. Good. It's a performance indicator and all. All right. Okay. Can we move on to the next slide, please? Okay. So when we talk about performance management, yes, most of you are right. This is one of the ways to evaluate an employee's performance as to what the employee has been contributing. It could be monthly, it could be weekly. Especially for sales, it is a performance that is evaluated weekly. For some of us, it is done monthly, and for some, it's quarter, half yearly, or annual. It is more like understanding where you are and where the company wants you to be. I would say, in my experience of the last 22 and a half years, I would say it's also developing an employee. Development of an individual also depends on how you do performance management, because it is not always telling somebody that you are not right, but it's also telling some of them that what you are doing right so far and where the company wants to see you. Because you have to understand, when you work at a workplace, when we talk about performance management, it is one is the individual employee's goal. Then you have a team goal, and then you have an organization goal. So all these three goals, it's like a triangle which is aligned to each other. Correct. I'm still getting the definitions. Very good. Performance. So most of you are saying it is an evaluation. Some of you said it's also a professional development. And I would agree to that, because at the end of the day, when the evaluation is done and when you start coaching an employee, you also need to tell the employee what are the development areas. So when you talk about a problem, you also talk about the solution with the employee. And I'm sure most of us, where we work, we heard about this term called the key performance areas. It is important that all of us know that what are the key performance areas that a person has. So for example, if it is like a recruitment area, right? So for a recruitment in HR department, we talk about how many employees did you hire, how much you spent, what is your each hiring cost. So your key result areas could be starting from the number of employees or number of people that you hire every month, from on how you also utilize the budget. So every department, every individual, every employee in whatever department you work, you have something called as the KRS, which is your key result areas where the company is expecting you to do a significant contribution from each one of you in the department. That's your key performance area. We have also, I'm sure, some of us, and please let me know in the comment box, have you heard about KPAs and KPIs? If you have not heard, it's okay. But if you have heard, please let me know what is your understanding of KPI and KPA. Anybody can put it in the comment box. What do you understand by KPI and KPA? Okay. Somebody said they did not hear. That's okay. Not a problem. Okay. KPI is important in the organization. I agree to that. So any idea what is a KPI? Okay. All right. No problem. So KPI and KPA is nothing but your key performance indicators. What is your performance indicator in the organization? It could be a critical function. It could be relevant to how you present yourself in a particular department or a particular role or position. It is also an indicator of a critical job that has been assigned to you in the particular department. It is also a significant critical contribution in the overall result. And it is definitely done as a specific goal that has been given to you. So most of the times in your organization, your KRA and your KPI both are aligned to each other. Now we will see how we need to set our goals to achieve the performance management. Can we move to the next slide, please? Next slide, please. Yes. Okay. All right. So we were talking about why do we need performance management? And I think here is the answer for most of you. There are, you know, many of you said it is, of course, the professional development. So we need performance management to develop. We need performance management to maintain your stability in the organization. We need performance management tools and performance management criteria to implement and execute a certain project. We need performance management to reduce the cost, to reduce the budget for each and every department that we have. We need performance management to increase our professional ability, to increase our productivity in the organization. So these are the things why we need performance management. And in order to do that, we also need to understand what we need, why we need, when we need, where we need, who is the beneficial person, and how do we do that. So these are the things that is there. In a psychological term, you know, we call it as five wives and one husband. If you see what, why, when, where, who, and then there is one how. So Rudyard Kipling actually, you know, invented this, and he would always call this as five wives and one husband. So every time you hear this, this is how you do it. So when we talk about goal setting, we will come to the next segment, which is again very, very interesting. So when we talk about that, I will let you know how you need to do that. Now, before that, let me ask another question to you. How many of you are currently working, and how many of you are, you know, just freshers and still trying to work? If you could just let me know. I will just randomly take some numbers as to how many working professionals have joined. And if anyone is from HR, please, please write that in the comment box. So I will just try to understand. Anyone from HR? How many working professionals? I will just randomly count and take the number. Okay. 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 All right. I have few from HR. I have a few working, and I also have teachers, I have HR, I have work from home. Okay. No problem. So now my next question, my follow-up question to this is, since there are people from HR, there are, you know, people from administration, teaching, and they, you know, I also have students from HR here. So can I ask the next question is, have you ever heard of the term SMART? S-M-A-R-T. I know all of us are smart, but there is a definition to each and every alphabet in SMART. So did anybody ever come across the word SMART? Let me see some answers this. I will just take it randomly. Okay. No, I'm not getting the answer for SMART. I'm still getting the working thing. I'm happy to see there are so many people from HR. HR and teaching profession, you know. I think the most noble profession is being a teacher. And we just celebrated the Teacher's Day in India. Okay. Okay. Somebody said, yeah, they heard about SMART, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time bound. Very good. Very good. So we are talking about SMART goals, right? In every organization, we work on this. So SMART is, of course, SMART is specific, M is measurable, achievable, relevant, and time bound. Now, I will give you an example on how we do that in terms of doing our SMART goals or writing our SMART goals in an organization in terms of how do you do a performance management. So if you notice and if you remember or if you recollect, most of the organizations have an annual system of appraisal, right? So most of the organizations will do a 12-month of period and then they will have a performance discussion. And it is also very, very important that you need to tell your employees where they stand and where the organization wants them to go. So it is very important that you set goals in terms of performance management. Now, let me give you a very, very interesting example of SMART. If somebody can give it to me, it will be great. But otherwise, I can give it to you right away. If you can just, anybody can think of any example for SMART, please do let me know. Just type there. Let me see if I can get some answers on SMART goals. Yeah, I got the definition for it. I'm just asking if anyone can give me the example. Any example? Okay. Some of you are asking for the presentation to be sent across. Unfortunately, I don't think I will be able to do that. So let's just focus on the slides that are being shown here. Please do not ask for the presentation. Okay. I can see there. Okay. Okay. Let me give you a very, very interesting example, and I will talk about a sales scenario. When we talk about SMART goals, you know, this is a very, very easy 5-step process, which is your first is specific. So the specific one, and if you want, you can make a note of this. The specific ones are which, what, who, where, when, why. These questions come into your specific goal. So for example, I want my team to increase the sales turnover. Now, what I want, the what part is here. I want my team to increase the sales turnover. That's my what. That's the first thing that you come across. The second one is measurable. Now, how much or how many, how much I want my team to work on. I want my team to increase a minimum turnover of $2,000 per month. So I measured it, how much I want. Now, is it achievable? Is it actionable? Yes. I need to describe the result, what I am trying to achieve. Now, what I'm trying to achieve, I have asked my team to increase the sales turnover. I also define that I need $2,000 per month. Now I'm saying that the sales turnover has been increased in a month because I wanted the team to achieve it. Now, when you come to R, which is your realistic and relevant, the realistic and relevant is to the individuals and the business. Now here, I will talk about that it is realistic because my team can achieve this. And it is relevant to the team and the organization. As a sales team, it is very, very important that you increase your sales turnover. So is it relevant to my team? Yes, definitely, because they are a sales team. Is it relevant and realistic for the organization? Of course, yes, because the organization is interested in increasing the sales turnover month after month. Now, how I am going to do that? I am going to be doing that by determining what is the business goal that the organization has. Now, this decision would also consider the current sales turnover and what is the time frame between now and the target date. And that's where I come to the last one, which is the time bound, which is the T, by when you want to achieve it. Now, today, 8th of September, I speak to my team that, you know, I want $2,000 increase in the sales turnover. So by say November 8th, which is the next 60 days, so I'm giving a time to my team to improve on that. And then I am saying by November 8, 2020, I want to see a $2,000 increase in the sales turnover. So I have covered all part of specific, measurable, actionable, relevant, and time-bound in my SMART goals. I hope this was clear to everyone. Am I clear? If you could just type and say that the explanation is clear to everyone, then we will move forward. I'm waiting for some answers. Very good. Somebody said in a teaching profession, SMART is very, very important. Absolutely. And I would say if you look at the current scenario, which is into this pandemic, and then, you know, most of the teachers, I think the most challenging part is the teachers and the students both, you are working from home. You are not going to the school physically anymore. You are just doing it over the video and over, you know, over the Zoom or over the telephone and all, which is not, again, which is very regular, which is not very regular for the student and the teachers both. So it's very important. And you also lost a couple of months. So for teaching profession this year, it will be very, very interesting if you work on your SMART action plans. All right. Now that it is most of you, thank you very much. So, I mean, 90% of you have said that the example is very clear and you're able to understand. Thank you very much. Can I ask all the people who are onto this session, who are listening and who are able to understand, can you please write a SMART goal for yourself of your current profession, of whatever you are doing right now? Anything that you are doing. You could be a student, you could be a teacher, you could be an HR professional and whatever profession you are. Please write a SMART goal without checking Google. Just write it on your own. And if you could just take a picture and then post it on your comment section, I would be able to see that. Please take 5 minutes and do that. Please take 5 minutes and do that for me, please. Please take a picture and put it in the comment section. Can we move on to slide number 7, please? Slide number 11. Slide number 7. Thank you. Just be there on that slide. Let me see what I have to get. I hope most of you are doing it. Somebody is talking about SOWT. Please understand, SMART and SOT both are different. SOT will come into a SOT comes into a problem solving tool and not into a performance management tool. Let me see if I can get some pictures on SMART goals. If you just say that you want to be a good instructor, then that is not a specific goal. You need to tell in which area, which department you want to be a good instructor. For example, if I just say that I want to be a teacher, that is not a specific goal. If I say that I want to be an excellent English teacher in the academic side, that is a specific goal. So that's how you need to explain. No, many of you are not able to understand the specific goal here. No. I'm again giving you the example, the specific goal. For example, if I have to say, I will say that I want to be an excellent English teacher on the academic side by the year end of 2020. By December 15th, I will acquire a certificate to be an excellent English teacher on the academic side. That's a specific goal. Okay, most of you are saying what is a specific goal, but you are not saying the other part of it. MART. Nobody has done that. That's the reason I asked all of you that if you could write down on a piece of paper. I'm sure you have it on a piece of paper, and then you know, or you can just type it and put it there. If you can't take a picture and send it, you can just type it and put it there, on your specific, on your measurable, on your relevant, on your actionable, and on your time bound. Please write SMART this way and then just define and say how you want to be. I want to become a teacher someday. It's not a specific goal. All of us want to become something someday, but you need to have a realistic. Okay, putting community fencing. No, 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 no. If you want to become something, then you need to have a specific targeted date for that. A date, a month, a year, and everything. It cannot be like, I just want to become someday. No. My goal in life is to become a progressive teacher. That's a very good thought. However, you have not explained when. You need to explain that. Okay, somebody is saying that I want to be the happiest person in this world, which is very nice. All of us want to be the happiest person, but there is no specific goal attached to it. Okay, all right, no problem. So I got randomly a couple of responses and answers. No problem. You can still you know, polish that, whatever you're saying. Let's move on and see. If you look at the slide, it talks about why do we need a performance management and goals which is set for an individual. What is the reason that we need? So the answer is very, very simple, right? In terms of, if you do not have a performance management or a goal set in an organization, then you will just be judgmental. You will not talk about the performance indicators that is defined. And here in performance management, from a HR professional, I would say that when we do a performance management, we talk on data, we talk on facts, we talk on figures that we have. We do not talk on opinion. If you talk about opinion, that is being judgmental. There is no data to prove that. It is like you are doing a performance management coaching and you don't have the data. You just say that I'm doing this because, okay, I give you rating of 1 and 2 because I don't like your nose. So that is not a performance management coaching. The performance management coaching will be like, you have the data to support, and the data will talk about, like, in the last 3 months, when I looked at the data from the biometric, I found that you have reported late 30 minutes to the office every week. That's data. That's your performance management data that you will talk to an individual. Here you're talking about the fact, you're not talking about the opinion. So that's the first thing, that you need to have the goals and the performance management data with you. The second one, why we talk about so much about goals and SMART goals that is there, it's about how you do the measurement in terms of what you have achieved in the last couple of years or couple of months, whatever. You could talk about 3 months, you could talk about 6 months, you could talk about 12 months. It is to understand how much you have achieved and how do I measure that. When you also have a performance management discussion and a coaching session with your employee, the employee is already expecting that there will be a result. The result could be, I get 50% on 100 or I get 100 on 100. At least the person is having an idea, or the person is expecting that there will be a discussion. The other thing is, it is also an opportunity for the employee and the boss or the management to have an open discussion in a, you know, in it's like a dialogue, it's like a feedback, it's like a coaching that's being given. The other idea of having a performance management is it also gives a job satisfaction to the employee that I understand that, you know, it's always to make the employee understand that whatever you contribute to the organization, it matters. Your work, your contribution is noticed, it is valued, and it matters to the organization. It's also a way of, you know, motivation of achievement that, yes, I, after joining this organization in the last 1 year, I have achieved this, I have achieved that. So it's also a satisfaction kind of a thing that I as an employee get why I work with the organization. So that's why it's very, very important to have a performance management discussion. Now, the most challenging thing here, and this is very, very difficult and very critical in every organization, the employee and the employer, or the employee and the manager, because most of us actually fail because the performance management discussion does not go in the positive side. It is either the boss is saying that you have done everything wrong and you have not done anything in the last 12 months, or I do not want to see you in the team anymore. So that is why it is very, very important that your discussion with your employee or your discussion with your team member, it has to be very, very productive and very, very positive, because it will be very difficult otherwise if you do not have a wonderful relationship, working relationship with your employee. It might again spoil somebody's career. And that is why we talk about coaching and feedback in a performance management to be the most difficult part of it, because you are telling somebody what this person has done. And most of the time why we fail, because there are people who think that whatever I have done is absolutely correct. Because most of us, and it's in my experience of 22 and a half years, I have seen that most of us are not open to feedback. The minute you say that you have done a wonderful job, everybody is very, very happy. But when you say that you were not good enough and this is what I had expected from you, then there is a problem. The person is not able to accept. And the person is thinking that you are finding faults with this person. And that is why there is a way, there is a process what we do in terms of how the performance management discussion has to happen. Now, that's something is called as, in a psychological term, I always go back to psychological terms, guys, because I am a practicing psychologist for over 22 years now. And I'm currently pursuing my PhD in clinical psychology. Also on my academic side, I also have a criminal law degree. So I kind of combine both this, and then I kind of try to talk to people. I've been heading HR departments of the last 20 years. So I kind of understand this. So I will tell you, there is a process that I follow, which is called as MEDIC. Now, I'm sure most of you will ask, what is MEDIC? Have you ever heard of this term? MEDIC. It's a term that we use while we do a coaching. Thank you very much. I'm getting a lovely, lovely comments. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, people. I see many of my friends from the Philippines. And I love the Philippines, guys. Lot many people from Pinas, though it is very late in the night in the Philippines. It's all past 9:30, but I still see, people are very enthusiastic and you have joined. Very nice. Okay. So I was talking about MEDIC, which is a process that we do in terms of performance management coaching. And let me tell you what is MEDIC. Okay. Somebody said, yes, I heard about MEDIC. Okay. I don't know. All right. So the first one of me, M, is I would say, when I talk to my team member, it's very, very important that I let the person first. I make the person very comfortable in the discussion. That's my first thing. My second thing is I have to motivate my team member, right? How many of you agree that it is important to motivate your employee or your team members? I think all of us need that, right? In whatever position you are, you need to be motivated. You just cannot be demotivated and doing a performance management discussion. Thank you very much. Of course, I was working in the Philippines, in Davao, Manila, Clark, Camsur. I just arrived back. So I love the Philippines and I will be going back next month. All right, okay. So we are talking about what is M. So the first thing is you motivate your team member. So medic is motivate first. Any idea what could be E? The first one is motivating. The second one is, if anybody can even just guess, I will be okay with that. Even if you can just guess. Yes, of course, motivation plays a very, very important role in this. Okay. The E here is evaluation. You first motivate your team, then you do the evaluation. It's important that you evaluate your team member, where this person is standing right now, and then where you want this person to go. It's okay. Somebody's saying emotional, no, but then if the first one is motivational, definitely. The second one is your evaluation, because you need to evaluate the employee who is sitting right in front of you. That's your E. Now, when we talk about D, the D is very, very interesting here, and most of the managers fail in this. The D is I, okay, let me just type it for you all. I demonstrate. The demonstration part here is if I want my team member to do exactly the way I want this person to do, then I, as the boss, I, as the superior or supervisor, needs to first demonstrate as to how I am expecting this person to do, what this person has to do. So it is demonstration. I first motivate the employee, then I evaluate the performance, and then I do the demonstration. It is not development. Of course, the development part is there, but it is how I demonstrate to my employee that this is how it needs to be done. And then once it is done, I expect in that discussion, I expect my team member to imitate me. That is I. I will tell my team member that, can you please exactly do the way I did it for you? If you remember, when you are a kid, most of us, we have done, most of us would love to play the way our teachers would teach us in the school. What is that called? That's called imitating your teachers. Most of us have done that, and I have done that many times, imitating your teachers. So that is the way I will explain my team member to imitate me and show me how I have, whatever he has learned from my demonstration. Of course, implementation is a part of it. I agree to that. But here in Medic, that this style, it is talking about the imitation part. Now, once I have motivated, I have evaluated, I have demonstrated, and the team member has imitated, now I come to the last part, which is my consolidation part or a conclusion part. I conclude saying that on this discussion, this is where we have achieved, we have discussed, and this is what we agree to each other. So that is my part. Now, if you look at it, does one style work for everybody? No. Maybe it will not work for everyone. It might work from some people, it might not work for other people. So you need to have different ways to kind of understand that what your employee is expecting from you, what your team member is trying to understand. It's not that always everybody would understand this way, but there are different ideas. Okay. Did anybody ever hear of, there is another model of coaching which is called as the GROW model? Did anybody hear that? The GROW model, which is very, very common in every organization. Most of the organizations currently, whether it is IT or call center or any industry, people are following something called as the GROW model. In the GROW model, okay, here, the another interesting thing, and I follow it most of the times, the GROW model, it works very well. G is for your goal. The goal is, what do you want? So many of you said that you want to become a teacher, you want to become a great human being, you want to do, you want whatever you want to achieve. So the first thing is, what do you want? What do you want to achieve? What do you want to become in life? That's the G part, the GROW model. I'm talking about the GROW model. The second one is the R, which is the reality. The reality is, where do you stand now? Where are you now? Where do you see yourself now? So that is your R part. That is the reality that is currently there. From your what do you want to achieve to where are you now? And then you come to the O part, which is the option. What would you do, or what could you do to change yourself? So for example, today I appeared for an English exam, and I achieved a score of 65 on a scale of 1 to 100. So my goal is, what do you want? I want to get 85% on this examination. But what is the reality? My reality is, I am at 65, which means I am 20% or 20 marks away from where I want to see myself. Now, what are the options that I have? What could I do? Do I have an additional coaching? Do I need, do I need to go for some more expert classes? Do I need to study so much and all this stuff? This is my option, that this is what I can do to achieve from what I will do. And then the W is for the ways. What will you do? The way is like, I will go online, I will read books, I will appear for practice tests, I will go for tutorials or whatsoever, so that I am able to achieve my goal. This model works very, very well. And most of the organization is now also focusing on this model, which is your grow. From your goal, where you want to be, where you are currently, what are the options that is available to you, and then what you actually can do, what are the ways to achieve it. If it is like, you know, I want to achieve 85% in my next examination, I am at only at 65 currently, but I don't do anything. I don't contribute anything to my development. I don't go for additional classes. I don't do anything, but I want to just get 85% out of it. Then it is very difficult. It needs to be like, what are the ways? How much of time I will go ahead and contribute? So as of now, to achieve 65%, I'm studying every day 4 hours. But to achieve 85, I might have to study for 6 hours or 7 hours. That's very, very important. Okay, somebody is saying that grow is very new. Yes, it might be new, but most of us are currently, most of the organization, we always use grow as a model, so that, you know, it is very, very important and very, very specific to our employees' contribution in the organization. Very good. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. All right. All right. Okay. All right. I'm getting good comments. I like it. Very, very positive. So far, so good. So far, do you guys have any questions, or was I able to explain it to you very, very clearly? I also gave some examples, but you can also use your own examples in the organizations that you currently work for, because I don't know what's the background that you have, what kind of employees you have, but most of us use it because it's very easy and employees will understand. But always remember, guys, when we do a performance management coaching, the performance management coaching here, we talk about goal setting, performance management. It is always to do a professional and personal development for the employee. It is not to tell somebody that you have been wrong, I don't like you, or, you know, it is not always negative. Please do not make your discussions negative, but please make it very, very interesting and very, very motivating, so that you are not, you're not spoiling somebody's career, or you're not spoiling somebody's motivational levels in terms of how you want to do that. After your discussion, maybe somebody will be very, very upset. They might not work anymore. But please ensure that you are able to develop and, you know, encourage that person and motivate that person in terms of how things need to be done. So please understand, these are the two models as of now that you could use, whether in whatever department you are, in whatever profession you are. Especially, I will tell you, you know, right now, if you look at the current situation, teachers are one of them. Right? Because most of the teachers, as far as my experience goes, and I know, you are not used to teach over the telephone. You are not used to teach on Zoom. It is not something that will come very, very easily to a teacher. But then you have no choice, because, you know, everything is closed and you cannot go physically to a school. But you have to teach, because that's your profession and that's the role that is given to you. So for a teacher, it's very, very important. And in my experience, and I have great respect for teachers, that a teacher can actually encourage, motivate, do everything for a child that is required for his development, in his future development. So I think it's very important that you do that. Thank you so much. You know, that's a wonderful feedback I'm getting. Thank you. You guys are actually motivating me currently and encouraging me to, you know, do it. Thank you. Thank you so much. I am truly, you know, truly overwhelmed. I appreciate this. Thank you. So everybody from the Philippines, for all your, you know, good words that you are saying, and Philippines is very close to my heart. There are people from Bataan. There are people from, I think people from most of the provinces have joined. So for all my friends in the Philippines, maraming maraming salamat po for whatever you are saying. Thank you so much. All right. Okay. So we will move on. And if you have any questions, you can always put it in the comment box. And then, you know, I can take that forward. Okay. All right. Can we move to slide number 10? Number 10. Okay. All right. Okay. Great. Just stay there on that slide. Okay. Now we are talking about, since we spoke about, you know, we spoke about the ways to do a coaching. We spoke about goal setting. We spoke a little about performance management. Now, what do you think? You know, most of the employees, in my experience, they think that the performance management is only, so please understand. Now, here is also another request that I have for everyone. Please understand that performance management discussion, the goal setting, is not only for just to increase your salaries, but it's also to increase your performance, your development, and your everything, your contribution and everything. Because there is also a benefit to you and a benefit to the organization as well. Because as long as you work, it's important because you are associated with an organization, right? So what is the benefit that this performance management could give you to an organization? It is the performance management thing, the tools that the organization will have. There will be a lot of clarity in terms of for the organization and the management to understand the employees, you know, what is the employee's contribution. It also talks about the capability assessment of an individual and the company both. It's not only you. The company is always not only finding faults to you. The company is also identifying where the company stands. What is that the company needs to do? What is the capability of that company? It is also a commitment to the objectives and results. As I told you, every organization will have a mission, vision, and goal. If you look at any organization, it could be for any department. It could be administration, HR, it could be operations, quality, anything, manufacturing, anything. Every organization has mission, vision, goals. And they need to understand that each and every employee that has been hired and that works in the company is aligned to the goals that the organization has. The next one is it will talk about the commitment. Now, for example, I hire somebody to do my recruitment process in a HR, and then this person does not understand anything on recruitment and is interested in an administration job. Then definitely I have a challenge. That means my hiring went wrong. I was not able to hire the right person here. I was talking about having that commitment because when I hire this person, I also need a commitment from this person that this person is aligned to my departmental goals, right? Now, if you have all these things in a person, it will give an overall direction for the company as to what the company is wanting to achieve. And if the employees that the company has hired are aligned to the company's goals and objectives. So it's very, very important that I have this performance management tool and the goals that are set for the employees to understand that if I am able to do it correctly or not. Do you have any questions on what I just said? If you agree, say yes. If you agree to disagree also, no problem. Just let me know that whether you agree to these things or not, because this is very, very important in any organization. Okay. Yes. What kind of way is better to motivation? There are different things for motivation. And please understand, when we talk about motivation, it is not always money. And this is in my experience that money always does not play a game of anything, right? If you think that just paying money, you know, just paying salaries on time, your employees will be motivated, then you're absolutely wrong. Paying salaries on time is a responsibility of the employer. However, I think there are very, very simple things which will boost your, you know, employees' morale and which will also increase the performance of the employee. It is like, you know, it's a simple thing, right? The employee walks in, your team member walks in, and you just say that, hey, you know, What's up? How are you? Did you have your food on time? How is life? Do you need anything? Please do let me know. I think everybody is looking for a friend when he or she is working in the organization because it's very important. Most of us spend almost 8 to 10 hours in the workplace. And if we do not have a friend, if we do not have someone who is, who is listening to us and who is ready to help us, then you are demotivated. Then your motivation levels, money cannot buy this motivation. So you have to also understand that in a performance management and a motivation part, it's not always the money. It's a simple thing that you do for your team member. So for example, I will give you a simple tip that I do for my team members in terms of motivation, right? It's not always money. It's not always rewards and recognition. It is a simple thing. I have a thank you note, which I have made for all my team members and employees. Now, anybody that I find has done a wonderful job or somebody who has gone beyond the duty of the working time, I will just write the name and I will say that I truly appreciate what you did for the team and the organization. Your contribution is valued and it matters to us. That's the thank you note, which is, I post it on the desk or I put it on the system or the laptop or wherever. I think this is one of the motivational ways, and it does not involve money, but involves emotions. So it is also important that you are a little emotionally attached to your employees as long as they are with you, so that they are motivated and they are able to do that. Because money cannot buy motivation, money cannot buy emotions. Money can definitely give you a spa voucher or a restaurant voucher, but money cannot give you what the person feels about you in the organization. So this is a very, very simple tip that I do, and most of the times it works for us because our rewards and recognition, of course, it's a part of it. But in the rewards and recognition, is it always the money voucher that helps you? No, it is not always that. It's a simple thing. So if you ask me, so in my organization, I do something like once in a year, a family day, where your family is invited, where your kids are invited. And if you are the award winner that evening, mostly it is done in the evening. So it's kept as a surprise, and it is your family member who is actually giving it to you. It could be your spouse, it could be your parents. So that's, I think, is one of the most emotional, motivational thing that a person can have, right? Because he or she does not expect this, and you do it very, very secretly. So, and I also, what I do is, somebody is a so. When you do a rewards and recognition, not everybody is a winner that evening. But if there are very selected people who are winners, so a bouquet goes to the residence of this person. I send a bouquet, then I send a box of chocolates, and I say that, so in the evening, let's meet in the evening and all. So this person does not know why a bouquet and a chocolate was sent. But this person is a winner. So we also do it for a birthday. We do it for an anniversary, right? This is a motivation. You give somebody a flower, I think that's good enough. So for me, if you give me a bouquet of roses, that's good enough. And the box of chocolate, you don't have to do anything for the next 3 4 months. It's also to let the employees know that how you feel about the employees' contribution, because most of us do not appreciate the team members. So that is very, very important. You just tell your team member no, that what you do matters to me. And you are a very, very important part of my team. Because unless and until you are able to do that and convey it to your team member, it is very, very difficult for the person to understand or for the person to continue work because he or she does not know that whatever I do, does it really matter? So you need to let the employee know that it really matters to you. So that's one of the ways. And these are the tricks that I do, tips and tricks. You can just do whatever you feel like. Because everybody wants to be treated very, very special. And I believe that you treat the person, the other person, the way you want to be treated. If I want to be treated special, then I equally treat you specially because I cannot expect that, I just don't treat you like anything. And then in return, you treat me very well. I cannot do that. So you have to really understand that. Now, these are very simple things that I do. You can do whatever works for you in your own department or own organization because every organization culture is very, very different. Okay, can we move on to slide 11 if you don't have any questions? Okay, I'm on slide 11, and if you have any questions, you can put it in the comment box. I'll try to answer. But then the comment box is scrolling so faster that I cannot understand most of the questions. But yeah, thank you so much. All I can say is very, very good things about the session, and I'm very happy that you guys like it. Okay, I'm just letting you know one of the checklists for performance management. You can use whatever you want, but this is how I make my checklist for a performance management discussion or a coaching with my team members. Because you, what I believe is, when you do a performance management discussion and a coaching, you need to be prepared. You just cannot do it because you have to do it, or the management says that, you know, there is a deadline and do it. You need to be well prepared. You need to have the data. You need to have the facts. You need to have everything ready with you before you talk to your employee. So when I do it, I actually check if the goals are actually being aligned and if the person is aware of the goals. Now, for you to do a performance management, it's very important that you make your employee, make your team member very well aware of what are the goals that this person needs to achieve. You just cannot do a discussion without letting your team member know that this is the goal that I defined for you. This is what I want you to achieve, and this is what you need to give it to me. This is your result area. That's very, very important. At the same time, you need to also see that the goals that you assign, or the goals that you give, or the goals that you set for your team member, realistic? Can you verify it at the end of the 6 months, at the end of the 1 year? You need to see that. I also, as a checklist here, if you see, I'm saying that the goals will indicate, right, the quantity, how much I want you to contribute, or how much is the sales turnover that I want to increase. What is the quality? Do I measure quality over quantity? Or for me, quantity is important and quality is not important. Did I give you a timeline or a deadline to complete? And at what cost did I give it to you? So these are the things that I will set for you myself. I will just not depend on you, and I will just not question you. Just because I am the boss, I cannot question you. If I do not give you realistic goals and I do not set these objectives beforehand, I have no right to question you. At the same time, I will also see that, are the goals that are assigned to you, are they really reasonable? Are they really realistic? And I will also see what are the priorities that I assign. So, for example, what I have done. Or at the same time, it is very important that I, as a manager, I, as a supervisor, also check that the goals that I assigned to you, did I already train you for that? Did I already give you enough information as to how you need to perform in your job? Or I just give it to you just because I think you can do it, and you know, I am the boss and nobody can question me. That's not the idea of the performance management. For the performance management, it's very important that when I give you a goal, I understand that what I have given you is a realistic goal. Otherwise, it is very, very difficult for you to perform. At the same time, I ensure that I develop you, I train you enough, I coach you enough to be able to contribute and to be able to complete this job. I will just not tell you that you have to do it. That is very, very important. Okay, any question? Okay, all right. Yes, most of us actually say quality over quantity. But there are, if you talk about a sales organization, sometimes the quantity is more important than the quality. It is not the quality, but the quantity is what they want to measure. But for most of the organizations, so for me, if you ask me as a HR professional, quality is very important than quantity. Because if you do not have a quality, then you will struggle with that. And I really want to work on a quality thing rather than a quantity. Most of you, okay, very good. Most of you are agreeing to quality than quantity. Very good, very good. Okay, do you have any questions so far? I have been talking. I want to see if you have any questions. Okay, all right. I think no questions. Yeah. For most of us, yeah, it is quality. Very good. The people understand quality over quantity. Okay. All right. Okay. Very nice. I got disconnected and I'm back. Okay, all right, okay. A lot of things have gone. I was unable to see because I missed it. Just give me a moment while I reconnect, guys. Just give me a moment while I reconnect. Can we move on to the next slide, please? Okay. This is also the checklist. I think we have already discussed about it. Just remain on this slide, on slide number 12. Just remain on this slide. I'm trying to reconnect my system and the mobile. Just give me a minute. There is a power cut. There's a brownout, and I cannot see anything. Just give me a moment. I'm not able to connect. I am back on the session. However, you know, there is like the hide and seek. There's a brownout. The power is not supporting me today. However, I'll try my best to, you know, to answer questions and answer anything that you have. And I can share some experiences if you would like to know some of the experiences that I have in terms of managing a performance management in my organization. Because I just cannot view my slides and all. Okay, as much as I wanted to do the other things, but sometimes the technological challenges that you need to bear with, you don't have an option. All right, so I know you have been waiting, and thank you for hanging in there and waiting. Yeah, thank you for understanding it happens. Yeah, finally I am back. Thank you. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much, guys. I mean, that's the only reason with this lot of positive feedback and your compliments, I am back again. Unfortunately, the power is playing hide and seek since morning. It's raining heavily here, I'm sure it happens to most of us, but I'm just trying to connect with my data that I have. All right, so we were talking about the checklist, we were talking about performance management, we were talking about goal setting. I gave you some information, I gave you some examples, I was trying to tell you. Now let me also I have one request, guys. Please do not ask for my Facebook ID. Let's just have it very, very professional. Okay, all right. So we were talking about the performance management. Now let me give you an example of how I'm sure if you are a supervisor or a manager, you might have had a challenge sometimes in your life or in your career of how to handle this performance management coaching, because sometimes it happens that, you know, you could be experienced like more than 30 years or 40 years, but when it comes to giving a feedback to a person in terms of how this person needs to do the job, it could be little, you know, it could be little challenging, because not every time that, you know, the positive energy that you have is also the same thing with your team member. It might not be the same case. Sometimes what you say, maybe your team member is not able to understand that. And so my tip for all of you, and it's from my experience, during a coaching session, especially when you talk about a performance management, especially when the feedback is not so great, the most important thing that you need to remember is what you say is not important, but how you say is the most important thing, because it might hit somebody very badly, or it might encourage and motivate somebody very, very positively. So you need to understand that. What you say is not important, but how you say is the most important thing. And that's why you have to understand that whatever you are planning to say, and that's also the reason why I said in the beginning that when you do a performance coaching, when you do a performance management review with your team member, it's very, very important that you are totally prepared. Once you are totally prepared with your data, with your information, with your facts and figures, then there is no way that you will be able to miss on that. And you will not be able to hurt, or nobody gets hurt emotionally when you have the discussion. But if you are not prepared, if you are just doing it because you have a deadline, you have to you have to do a coaching with all your employees, then it becomes very, very difficult. So you need to understand that. And that's my experience of 22 and a half years. Whenever, even till date, whenever I do a coaching with my team member, I always prepare. I set the entire scenario in such a way that this person is very comfortable. The other thing that I do, and it might work for some of you, again, it's your wish and choice whether you want to try it or not. I do not do my performance management discussions most of the time in my regular office cabin, in my office room. I do it somewhere else just to make the environment a little, you know, little comfortable, little encouraging for my team member. Somebody should be, when you call your team member for a performance management discussion, you should make the person feel comfortable. No, that person should not be scared to talk to you, because everybody thinks that whenever you call your team member for a performance management discussion, it is always negative. No. So you need to understand that it's not always negative. It again depends on how you make the scenario or how you make the situation very, very comfortable for this person. And I totally believe till date it happens to everyone. It also happens to me when my boss calls me for a discussion. I am like, oh my God, what is he going to say now? And for most of the employees in the junior level, I have understood that unless and until you make the situation and the scenario comfortable, there is always one thing that goes in the person's mind that, will I lose my job? Is my boss going to fire me today? So you need to make that discussion very, very positive and very, very interesting. Otherwise, you will not be able to achieve. If you demotivate the person, if you hurt the person emotionally, then there is no point that you are going to extract a performance out of this person. So this is my way. This is how I think. You might think the similar way, or you might have a different way. But I understand everybody has a different way of coaching. But for me, coaching, if you are coaching somebody on a performance, it's absolutely about you are developing that person and you're taking the person to the next level. This person cannot remain at the same number. So you need to actually develop this person on a personal side, on a professional side, both. And people from India, whoever is listening, I think one such example of a movie that comes to my mind when I talk about it is how the performance management and the coaching does, is if you remember the movie Chak Dey India. That's one movie which is like very, very aligned and very, very relevant to what we do. People outside the country might not understand that movie. But I'm sure you can find out with the subtitles. That's one movie which talks about how the coach improves the performance personally and professionally. He develops all of his team members, and from nowhere, somewhere, nothing, he takes the team to the world championship, and then they win the World Cup and all. I think that's like one of the most significant and most critical contribution that a coach can have in somebody's life. So please remember that when you do it. And guys, I would like to say that performance management is a very, very critical component in everybody's career for every organization. It talks about vision, mission, goals, and it has to be aligned to the company's objectives. So let's work together on that. And on that note, I would say, since I'm facing a challenge in terms of connecting to the audio and this link, I have to end this today. But I'm sure you had got some points. You were able to make some sense out of whatever I said. I will be happy to answer some questions. If you could just, ask me questions relevant to the session that we had today, I will be more than happy to answer that. And for all the wonderful people, there are more than 600 people joined today with us on this live session. I'm very, very happy, very excited, and it was a very, very positive session that I had. It was a great opportunity. And to everyone who are associated with this session from Institute of Global Professionals, it's a wonderful evening, and thank you so much, guys. People who are, people globally, you are present here. Hello?
Thank you, ma'am. Now we have a short interaction
I
with.
cannot hear, but I don't know. I think I have a problem with my connection. I cannot hear anything. I think somebody is trying to talk.
Ma'am, are you audible? Hello? Ma'am, am I audible to you? Thank you for the wonderful presentation. There are approximately 5,000 comments in chat box. So many people are participated from India, Bhutan, Myanmar, Philippines, Bangladesh, Nepal, as well as other countries. We review the chat box. So many wonderful remarks and comment reflection are there. So it is very interesting. We are very much pleased of the wonderful chat. Some technical error that happened during the presentation, we are extremely sorry for that. It's beyond our control, we know that. So we are sorry for the some technical interruption during the program, especially mem side. We will manage in the next session. So lastly, I would like to thank all the participation who have been enjoying this seminar from around the SAR countries. Thank you all for being with us for the whole session with kind cooperation and sincerity. I would like to thank respective Plomi for our wonderful presentation with long lasting impression, because all the participants are pleased with her, her wonderful words. We would like to gratitude organization. We are really indebted to her, and it's a privilege to have with her in this session. Thank you for the participant, for active participation, and finally to all management team, Institution of Global Professional. We are releasing feedback team shortly. We have a huge participant members, because it makes us some technical difficulties. So we ask all the participant to fill up their forms in a scheduled time framework. So we are letting you to fill the feedback form shortly. Thank you for the all participants. So dear friends, we are releasing feedback form. The forms are same as we did previously. Feedback form 2S, 3K, 4A. In your convenience, you can choose any one of them. If any couldn't let, then choose another one or another one. You have your own choice. It will be closed shortly. You can write your comments in the Facebook page. We welcome your comments offline too. Any suggestion to improve the program is heartily welcome. Please keep in touch with us, and let's move together to make it fruitful, more beneficial. We are wishing to get constructive feedback from the participant. We believe you all guide us, make it more fruitful, more impressive, more constructive. Thank you for the active participation.